Welcome back, and in this series of lessons, I'm going to take a sample question which you might find in the exam and break it down. I want to help you understand the process that I go through when answering questions. Now, the questions that I'm going to step through in this section of the course are taken from a number of sources. We have questions taken from my practice exams in this course, as well as a few sample questions from Tutorials Dojo. Now, for anyone who doesn't know, Tutorials Dojo specializes in high quality practice exam questions, and they've kindly agreed to help me use a few to break down in this section of the course, so I highly recommend checking out their content if you do need some extra practice exam questions. At this point though, let's jump in and get started. Now I want to start by presenting the sample exam question. And the question is, traffic is leaving an EC2 instance towards a destination address 1.3.3.7. The route table has the entries below. Which route will be used? Now, sometimes I like to review the answers to a question first to give me clues I can use while reading the question text. In this case, the question itself looks pretty simple. Word of warning here though, this is always a sign that there is some nuanced aspect to the question. So if the question itself is brief, especially if the answers are also brief, then you should expect there to be a very particular set of details that you need to be aware of. With short questions like this, I always start with some simple keyword identification. I'm looking for things in the question which pop out as being important. Now at this point, go ahead and pause the video and take a moment to look yourself. What do you see in this question which pops out? Once you've had an attempt at this, resume the video and we can step through together. Okay, so at this point, I hope you've had an attempt at identifying any keywords in this question. So let's step through and compare what we found. What I found is this. We see that traffic is leaving an EC2 instance. When answering networking questions which involve any form of traffic flow, pay attention to the direction because it's nearly always important. Sometimes it can affect cost. Remember, data is free when inbound to AWS but carries a cost in an outbound direction. Sometimes the direction can affect security or routing. I also spotted the address which the traffic is headed to. That's important, so 1.3.3.7. And I can also see that route table is mentioned, as well as the question asking which route is used. Why does any of this matter? Well, remember, route tables can have multiple routes. Do you remember how AWS selects between multiple routes? Well, generally the first rule is that the longest prefix wins. The more specific a route is, the higher the priority. This gives us a lot of clues. Assuming that there's nothing crazy with the answers, we need to check which routes match and which don't, and then if we have multiple matching routes, we need to pick the most specific. Okay, let's look at the answers and see what we have. We have 255.255.255.255/32, 1.3.3.6/32, 1.0.0.0/8, 1.0.0.0/16, and then finally 1.3.0.0/22. At this point, I want you to pause the video and review each answer based on what I just said about route selection. When you're ready, resume the video and we can compare the technique that I used as well as what I found out about each of the answers. Okay, let's take a look and compare what we found. I started by thinking about routes based on two different elements. Remember, these are in CIDR notation. So on the left we have the IP or the network, on the right we have the prefix, which is the size being matched. The largest network in an IP version 4 route table is 0.0.0.0/0, which matches all possible networks, but /0 is the lowest priority match. At the other extreme is a /32 match, which is a single IP address, but it's also the highest priority. Now we have five possible answers, but straight away I can see something which will help us out. This one is not valid. /32 is a single IP, and 255.255.255.255 is a broadcast address. This is not something which is valid in this context. It's not a valid item on a route table, and so the answer self-eliminates. This is something that you should always be on the lookout for. Do any answers self-eliminate? Because if they do, if they're invalid, or if they're just plain stupid, then you can remove them without comparing them against the question, and this can save us significant time under exam conditions. The next thing that I would look at is to identify any of the answers which are obviously incorrect. Well, the second answer, let's take a look, 1.3.3.6/32. Because it's a /32, it means that it's a single IP address match. It matches 1.3.3.6 only, and so this 2 can be eliminated. Now we're at the interesting part of the question, because with the last three answers, nothing is immediately invalid or obviously wrong, and so we just need to check if they match, and if they do match, how specific they are. Well, the third answer, 1.0.0.0/8, is a /8 prefix, and so it does match RIP. A /8 means that as long as the first octet matches, which is a 1, then the second, third, and fourth octets don't matter. 1.0.0.0/8 matches everything from 1.0.0.0 through to 1.255.255.255. And this includes 1.3.3.7, which is our IP address. Now, what we can't do is say whether this answer is correct or not, because for multiple matches in a single route table, there's also the rule that the longest prefix wins. So for now, this answer could be possible, but we also can't exclude it. Now answer 4 is 1.0.0.0/16. This is a /16 prefix, which means the first two octets need to match our IP address, and this isn't the case. 1.0.0.0/16 matches 1.0.0.0 through to 1.0.255.255, and this doesn't include our 1.3.3.7 IP address, and so it's wrong and can be excluded. Lastly, we have the final answer, 1.3.0.0/22. Now, my trick in exams is to start with the closest network size that you're comfortable with, so that makes sense to you. In this case, I suggest a /24. You know what a /24 is. It means any value in the last octet of an IP address. At this point, you can decrease the prefix, which doubles the size, and if you increase the prefix, it halves the size. So this means that a /22 is equal in size to 2/23 subnets or 4/24 subnets. This means that 1.3.0.0/22 matches from 1.3.0.0 through to 1.3.3.255. So this is a possible correct answer, and in this case, it's more specific than the third answer, the /8, and so it's picked to use within a route table. This also eliminates the third answer, because while the third answer does work, it's not selected because the fifth answer is more specific. And that's it. It seems like a simple question, but this is actually a question that I think would cause many students some difficulty in exam conditions. The key parts really are knowledge about which route is selected in a route table based on either only one applicable route or multiple applicable routes. And then you need to have the ability to know from a given IP address using CIDR notation, so network or IP, and then the prefix, you need to be able to calculate the start and the end of that network range. And if you can do that, awesome. If you can't, then that's something that you need to practice to be able to answer questions like this in the exam. Now, at this point, that's all I wanted to talk about. This has just been the breakdown of one sample exam question. At this point, go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.